So I got a request from someone who was having trouble recovering their seed phrase, and the issue for them was they only had Litecoin addresses and were struggling to make them work with BTCRecover. So I took the plunge, did some quick and dirty patching to BTCRecover, and now it works with Litecoin addresses. And I'm just going to run through a quick demo of how to use that here now. And if you haven't already done so, hit subscribe, and that can help you to stay in the loop with future content I make that helps you to find your way in the crazy and hostile space that is cryptocurrency. So like all my other videos on BTCRecover, there's a few important things you need to understand at the beginning in terms of how BTCRecover can recover an invalid mnemonic, an invalid seed phrase where you might have made an error transcribing your seed words. And the first thing is, don't ignore the security warnings in my other videos about using BTCRecover. They are covered in the other videos, so I won't rehash it all here. You will need your 24-word seed or whatever the best guess of that is. You simply cannot just derive private keys from a bunch of public keys or addresses. And you will need to know at least one public address that you used with this wallet for this procedure in this video. So for the examples here, let's just say that you purchased some Litecoin on Coinbase and you found a record of the address that you sent it to. And that's the one you'll be using for your recovery. So step one is you need to set up your environment both to run BTCRecover in terms of creating a secure environment to run it in, and also to download BTCRecover. And for this video, you'll actually need to download a fork of BTCRecover from my GitHub, because I've actually included some quick and dirty changes that allow BTCRecover to recover using Litecoin SegWit and Litecoin legacy addresses. I plan to neaten this up and expand its functionality in the future, but for now, it's good enough just to get some folk out of trouble who are waiting for a solution. So once you've got your environment set up, you're ready to run seed recover. And I would suggest that you just replicate the demos that I have here just to make sure that you've got the software working right before you try and throw all of your own seeds at it. So the first example we're going to look at is just a legacy Litecoin address. It's pretty much the same as Bitcoin. The only difference really is the derivation path, which is essentially the standard Litecoin legacy derivation path for account number zero. That's the zero on the end. We're just going to look for one big typo and this address here. So we say run. We don't have a wallet, so we're not going to worry about that. We're just going to say we have a standard BIP39 wallet. We don't have an XPub key. And the address we're going to use is this Litecoin address here. Now, our best guess for the mnemonic is going to be this one here, where the word side has been incorrectly transposed as size. You know, really easy mistake to make. So let's go. There we go. Found a result. So that is it. It's found and identified the incorrect word and shown what the correct one is. So that is great. So now we'll just show it running using a Litecoin SegWit address. So this is an address starting with an M. So again, we're just going to do pretty much the same command as before, but the key difference here you'll notice is the derivation path we are using is the Litecoin SegWit derivation path. So it's now M49200 rather than M44. Everything else is the same. So we just hit go. We say no, we don't have a wallet file. Just using standard BIP44. Don't have an XPub key. We're going to put in this address here. And our best guess of the seed, and we're just going to use the same seed with the same error as before, and hit OK. And there we go. So single word error, it's found in a couple of seconds. And to be honest, a single word error in your seed phrase is pretty much, from what I've seen, the main issue that people have when it comes to an error in their seed phrase. At this time, BTCRecover doesn't work with native SegWit addresses for Bitcoin, Litecoin, or anything else. But, you know, that's again something that I'm happy to look into in the future when I get some spare time. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Hit like if you think that other people would find this video useful, and hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make that helps people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. If you have any questions about this video or a topic that you'd like me to cover, just leave a reply.